symbol of excellence, CAW Entertainment.
There ain't no grave can hold my body down. There ain't no grave can hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna rise right out of the ground. Ain't no grave can hold my body down. Ain't no grave can hold my.
And welcome everyone to another edition of the Superstar Clash. And we begin with the demonic Hellboy.
My evil way.
We are hot off the roads of Autumn Anarchy. We welcome you to this capacity crowd here in Vancouver, where we are tonight.
What do you think I see? I see a bear.
And on
a
Anarchy, that man, that monster right there, got a pinfall on the SCW Legends Champion six-man tag team match. And now we're going to hear from Hellboy to kick off Superstar Clash 229. Glad you joined us. Hellboy making a vow to send Elric to here respond, no doubt, as the SCAW Legends Champion. The title that this man has held since Blood, Sweat, and Tears 10. We're waiting, there he is. Turned back a number of challenges since he won that title almost a year ago. You can see we've got a full house here in Vancouver. I am Lone Star as always for SCAW. We've got several big matches set to take place on tonight's program. We're starting things here, Hellboy in the ring, and he seemingly called out Elric. Now to send him to hell. Words of Hellboy saying he's he's the reason Elric has become the man that he is. Thank you. In a cell? Hell in a cell? Is that what he's talking about? Oh, he tried to hit him with the belt. Oh, but no. Throws him to the outside. Oh boy, and Edward Elric battling for the inside. Can you imagine? As he knocks him off the apron again. Hellboy standing tall. I think I like the idea of those two inside Hell in a Cell. Oh wait, what's this? Wait, that's Anakin jumping into the ring and attacking Hellboy. Well, I know he's been a victim of a number of beatings at the hands of Hellboy, but this is not the time or the place to get himself involved. They throw his ass over the top and knock him to the floor. Oh, in the meantime, Edward Elric just grabbed his belt and run off. Now Anakin. The Hellboy's going to deal with Anakin now. Set into the table there. Hellboy is now dealing with Anakin as he sends him into the stairs. And I got a bad feeling about that table. And then, back comes. Into the. The table. I got a bad feeling about Anakin and that table now. Is Hellboy going to send a message? I hope you're watching, Edward. Because this is going to be you off a cell. Oh, man! Through the table. Elric is taking off because he knows. He wants nothing to do with that. Oh, we got a big program coming up. We have the tag team champions, 80s Express will face Shazam, and the Gladiator non-title matchup. Tag champs fighting, they're fighting their former partners. It's going to be interesting. But, you know, coming up just moments, we're going to have an Extreme Rules women's match between Sombra and Cypha, and that's in just a few moments. That and a whole lot more is going to take place here tonight on the Superstar Clash. Glad you've joined us. Make sure you stay with us. We've got a whole lot to come. Superstar Clash 229.
For 36 years, one man has walked the aisle with a flair like no other. His charisma and charm have endeared him to millions of fans across the globe. His skill and technique between the ropes have made him a master of his craft and one of the most decorated champions in wrestling history.
He is the best wrestler of all time.
The greatest wrestler never laced up a pair of boots.
My first time that I seen him wrestle, he was like, I was hooked from that point on. You can feel his emotion, and you get caught up in his emotions.
He just has that ability to connect with our fans.
The passion comes through because it's genuine.
My God, an unbelievable performer.
He's probably one of the toughest guys out there.
You feel his passion for this business.
Really soft-spoken, nice guy.
Extraordinary performer.
A true pioneer and true legend.
He had an incredible wrestling career.
You get the door slammed in your face so many times, you get the rug jerked out from underneath you, just pack your bags and go home, and you quit. And I haven't done that yet. I don't plan on doing that. And at this point in my career, all eyes are looking at me, and I don't plan on failing.
So, Mr. Clean?
Everything can be.
We don't actually have a Hall of Fame, but if he had one. I think the Call Hall of Fame had one. Mr. Clean was recently no DQ world champion before he lost it to Walter White of Breaking Bad, really? And that indeed is Sombra. The rather arrogant hacker. We've had issues with Sailor Moon and Sypha Belnades. Number of matches between Sypha and Sombra have taken place, and we're going to have another one tonight. It's going to be Extreme Rules, apparently. Last we saw Sombra, she was taking on Sailor Moon in the back. Look up at the sky. Oh. But tonight, it's about dealing with Sypha, the Mad Forest Mage. Had to deal with Sombra for quite some time. They both came in to SCAW around last year. They've had a number of matches against each other, and well, tonight's going to be another one of those matches. Oh wait, when is Netflix going to announce Season 3 of Castlevania? I want to know. I've heard some... very little. Anyway, we've got a lot going down here on this clash. We're here in Canada tonight. Yes. Vancouver. It's going to be Sombra taking on Sypha. Remember, no disqualifications or countouts in this match. These two have a history of beating the hell out of each other, so we might as well do it in Canada. Canada is a lot like hell, only it snows a lot less. It snows a lot more. Actually, there's less snow in hell, and thus it is less like hell. Because snow sucks. We're going for the toys now. It's going to be Sypha's got the Singapore cane in Canada. Oh, and a suplex on the floor. Now, it is not false count anywhere like a hardcore match. Speaking of hardcore, we had a new hardcore champion at Autumn Anarchy. He's with the chair right back into Sombra's face. And now, what's this? It's like it's flippy stuff to get out of that arm hold. And now it's going to send her into the barricade. Now, okay. Now what? What's she doing here? Wait, what's that? No. Okay, she's going to do this too, really? Come on. Back into the ring now. Oh, and she's brought the cane in, and oh my goodness. Here we go. Oh my goodness. Shots right there. Run right in the midsection. A drop kick. That could be it right there as a referee. Oh, only gets a one count off that. Now she's going to try a suplex. And another pin attempt. And that does get two. Speaking of women's matches, we saw not only did Harley Quinn successfully defend the SCW Women's Championship, but it's the chair now by Sombra. But we saw Amy Lee defeat Kurumi Tokusaki, only to take a beating afterwards. Oh, nice Rana there by Sombra. And there at this moment, oh, that did not work, I think, like she hoped it would. Now into the steps you go. And now, we just lost this table like 5 minutes ago. We're going to lose it a second time in 15 minutes. The show is 16 minutes in. And we could lose... Oh, well, this is dangerous stuff here. He's going for the steel stairs. Oh, my... Oh, how do you avoid that? But you don't for long. Got a shot with those steps. It's personal between these two. Suplex on the stairs! And now into the table once more. And to the table. And they're gonna powerbomb her on the oh no! Powerbombed her on the floor and now into a crab! I'm gonna powerbomb her on the table, but maybe she could lift her into it. I don't know. And back comes Cypher. And then into the table again. And about a suplex on the floor. Those always hurt. And a Cypher! Oh, she missed! These two continue to tear into each other right here. Back in. Uh-oh, now she's got... What's she gonna do here? Oh! What a suplex! Almost got her on the chair right there. And gets a two count. And then a chair in the midsection, right in the stomach. And then another suplex. Now, oh no, she's going for that move, the down low, got it! Oh! And that's it. One, two, three, no! Kicked out of the download. That's what they call them, what we call that move. And Sombra. You don't see. You can, Sombra. She, oh, not even the referee. See, she's got an angry side, but so does Cypher. A super kick to the face right there. And then I roll with the ref. Oh, ref is down. That's a three count right there. But there's no ref. And then, oh no, the referee gets knocked down again. The spring off the ropes. Now, oh, back Cypher. Oh, what a neck breaker. Like a regal cutter. And then, now, gonna get the three here, no! Got the shoulder up. Now get the moonsault! What a moonsault! Got it! One, two! Oh, close! That missed. Uh-oh. Look at the... recovered from that. Landed on her feet. Neither knew what to do there. That's Sombra. Now right there's the chair. Oh, my God. What a... Right, brained her with that chair. That's gotta be it. Oh no! Suplex on the chair! Good God Almighty! And that Sabra! Oh my goodness! Number of moves right there! What a match to start this program! Another Rana on the floor there! Now what's Sombra gonna do? Gonna try and get her to get like a clover leaf. I don't know what we're calling that. Was she tapping out? I think she was, but there's not false count anywhere. And back there, Cypher is up. And now she's got a sleeper hold. She's got a sleeper on. She is a user of magic. Scholar of magic, if you will. Oh, there's no matter if she was going to get DDT'd in the floor right there. No magic was going to save her. Well, Cypher once moved Dracula's castle with her magic abilities. Uh-oh. Now we're going to say bye-bye to the table. Yeah, oh my God. There goes the table. Blatant net right there. Just ignore that. Now back in the ring. Remember, can finish and get a pin right there. I think this could be it. Oh, missed a leg drop. Trying to springboard leg drop. I think that was a mistake. Oh, DDT! Like a straitjacket DDT! And that Sombra could get it! He didn't! No! How close was that? Uh-oh, now there goes that turnbuckle. Well, there's no disqualifications. Everything's legal here. From behind. Wait a minute. Let the Mad Forest Rage, yes! In the middle of the ring! The Mad Forest Rage! Can she get the submission? Can she get it? Can she? No, no! Sombra's able to escape it and into a pin here! One, two, and oh, how close was that? Oh, comes right back. It's that move right there. Somehow that chair ended up there. But she just kept up like Shawn Michaels. But there goes the chair. Drop kick. Another shot right there. And another one. Oh, suplex. May have caught the chair. And then, oh, definitely caught the chair. She kicked the chair in her face. Good going down. Great googly moogly. Oh, exposed turnbuckle. Oh, she's got to be out after that. And now there's submission hole in the ring. And that's it. And Sombra has won it.
And everyone.
What a battle that was. It really could have gone either way, but Sombra in the end, the right weapons, the right positioning, the chair, exposed turnbuckle, and now Cypher rolled out of the ring. What now? Brings her back into the ring. What now? Oh, come on, the match is over. This is not sportsmanlike at all, come on! Wait, hold on. That music. Is it? It's gotta be the Champion of Justice. This Sailor Moon is here. Entrance and all. And she's had problems with Sombra as well. Now they're running into the ring, and here we go! I don't think this is a match, but... Sailor Moon is in trouble, or not! You thinking about a spear? The moon hammer? Irish whip? Oh! I didn't spear out of midair. I don't know why she didn't do that there. You throw her out of the ring and spear off the... Oh, that was countered by Sombra! They continue to battle here. And... Oh, Sailor Moon got backdropped out! How far she's... There's to do some damage to the Champion of Justice, and oh my goodness! Now Sombra. These two have been having problems, but Sailor Moon, since she's come to SCW, has been, for the most part, seemingly bulletproof. Now struggling a bit in this. This is not a match. She got her back in the ring. And... Wait, don't DDT! He countered it! I was going for like a moon hammer or something. No, that ain't Suguri! Now what's she gonna do? I think she's gonna do that download, but now Sailor Moon has moved. Missile drop kick. Well, now she's gonna try it. Oh, but Sailor Moon got up, avoided it again, and another one. Missile drop kick from behind. And this crowd is getting quiet. Is there perhaps? Nice to see that their hippie of justice is having... Oh, another DDT there! Oh, no, now she's gonna hit that download. She's been wanting to hit that. Here we go. No, oh, Sailor Moon moved out of the way! The clothesline over the top! Sailor Moon defeats Sypha in the Extreme Rules and then holds her own against Sailor Moon. But things could be turning here as a dive! Now, Irish whip is reversed. Like they're gonna go all the way up the ramp. Someone's gonna send Sombra back into the ring. And now Sombra. I think she's had enough of Sailor Moon. And she's running away. But Sailor Moon may find Sombra to be a challenge. She's running off the stage. But Sailor Moon may very well find Sombra to be her greatest challenge since coming here to SCAW. Whoa, it's Bruce Wayne is here! Bruce Wayne is here in Canada. We haven't seen Bruce Wayne. He actually present on our program in quite some time, and he shows up tonight. We're set for a match here. It's going to be Wesker of the Celestials. And he's going to be in action just a moment, but let's talk about Bruce Wayne showing up, because we didn't expect that. Mr. Wayne is here, and he just had a discussion with Green Lantern, and now instead of having a rematch between Liu Kang and William Wallace, now they're going to be a tag team? Okay. Oh, and by the way, they just made it official. And to hell and back, it's going to be Edward Elric defending the SCAW Legends Championship against Hellboy inside Hell in a Cell that is now set for to hell and back. That is our next mega event. Now up next, we're going to have Albert Wesker. Going to be facing Ryu Hayabusa one-on-one. Going to be facing a man who did not become the 0-1 champion. At Autumn Anarchy, he had a chance to become a six-time 0-1 champ, but let's see. Shin Kazuma using the ropes for leverage. He walked away, still the champ. Now it'll be Ryu taking on another member of the Celestials in Albert Wesker for some reason. Going to be taking place now. Keep in mind, we still have the 80s Express they're going to be facing. Their former partners in tag team action here tonight. And a whole lot more. By the way, each of these will be three parts. Each will be about 45 minutes long. What a shot right there. And then, oh my God. What a dive move right there. When he avoids that kick, Wesker is very dangerous. Sent into the stairs. Another shot right there, and another kick. Waves to the stairs again. The count is up to 6, 7. And then, oh, knee to the gut there. A member of the Celestials, former tag team champion. We got Ryu, 6-time 0-1 champ. He's also been a tag team champion as well. He's been Legends champion as well. He's been around literally since day one. He was in the first SCAW match. First official one. But right now, we got Wesker is like working over body parts. That's a vile move. Knees right to the chest. But, oh, and he put all his body in that, and it was not a good move. It's about a Smart an Idea is a game based on bees. Oh, now it's almost as smart as a game based on bees. In case you're wondering, there's actually a game called Bee Simulator. And it, oh, nice drop kick there off the ropes. But back comes Wesker. But the Wesker's curse, he got it. And now hooks the leg. Ref gets down and gets a two count. And now he's got him locked in a rest hold here. Wesker, uppercut right there. Wesker did not compete at Automanarchy. Ryu did, although we should see Wesker get involved. Oh, he missed that dive there. So we saw Wesker get involved. He attacks Superman. Following this match, and oh, Wesker's curse to the floor. Before Aquaman came out and took care of business. Then we saw Archie Andrews and Drax get involved. And it was chaotic. Speaking of which, we've got a big announcement regarding the next title internet title match we're going to have and when it's going to take place. Well, we've got a big announcement about a big historic show that's coming up in the next, and we'll talk about it a little bit later, but now we've got small package here. You can get two count. It's Ryu. And now another, well, it's like a third one he's done in this match. What, does he think he's going to spear him like he's Edge? Oh, he's going to decapitate, that was a decapitating clothesline. Back comes with a suplex. Well, back comes Wesker though. And now he's got Ryu in the corner. And, oh, nice move right there. And then he continues the uppercut. And now he's, oh, look at this. Oh, look, my goodness. Look at this hold. It's like a modification. He's got him like, but he managed to escape it. And he's pretty angry. Oh, he ducked the clothesline there. And get out of the way, ref! Oh, what a rana! Almost ruined by the ref being in the way. And he's got him in the corner. Uh-oh, face first into that turnbuckle. At least they put the pad back on. Now it's real. Oh, how do you change directions like that? How do you do that in midair? Now Wesker took advantage of that miss, and now he's got this hold on of Ryu, but he's going to try and fight his way out of it. And he's out. And now he's kicking him good here. Oh, there's a shot right there. That could be it. He's thinking axe kick. Or, oh, how about the Hayabusa stretch? He's got it on Wesker. Hayabusa stretch. Gonna get the submission here. He's got it on, he may have to tap out. He may have to give up here. Or maybe not. He's recovered, just nonchalantly sidewalk slammed him. Miss right there. Now, oh, flapjack. And a shot. chest. Oh, knee right, kick right to the knee. Missed the clothesline again. Got him in the corner. What's he thinking about here? Well, this could be interesting. Or it could be devastating. Oh, and now Wesker on the top rope. Elbow drop. There's a cover. One. Two. Only two. Another fine matchup to start this clash. It's going to continue here. How about an axe kick? Yes. Axe kick. Got it. Hayabusa axe kick. Big time connection. Two. Three. Oh, he kicked out. Clothesline there. Punch. Kicks. Another one. He hit him again. And then, oh, back comes Wesker again. And another! It's like the fourth time! Now you gotta think he's going for the turning evil here. Hayabusa knows it. Manages to get out of it. Backflip for some reason. Now Hayabusa is a Hayahasa fire!